How are you?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
The reason for most violence against gays is that heterosexual men are forced to prove that they themselves are not gay. It goes like this. Men in strong male subcultures like the police, the military, and sports, and a few other cesspools, they bond very strongly. Hunting, fishing, and golfing friendships also produce this unnatural bonding. These guys bond and bond and bond, and they get closer and closer until finally they're just drunk enough to say, "You know, I really love these guys." And that frightens them. So they quickly add, "But I'm not a queer." See the dilemma? Now they have to go out of their way to prove to the world, to their buddies, and to themselves that they don't harbor homoerotic feelings. And it's only a short step from "I'm not a queer" to "In fact, I hate queers." And another short step to "Let's go kill some queers." And what they really seek to kill is not the queer outside, it's the queer inside they fear. Gay bashers are repressed homosexuals attempting to deny the queer inside. But certain signals get past the screen. That's why you see so many policemen with those precious little well-groomed mustaches. You'd see more of the same mustaches on athletes and military men, but those two groups are not allowed to express themselves freely. Military drones and many sheep-like athletes have dress codes and are forbidden to wear facial hair. The idea is to limit and reduce their individuality. These are men who have chosen to allow the organization to run their lives. That's why athletes, police, and military men have that rigid, unbending body language. They're severely repressed. Guess what they're repressing? Why do you think they call those police cars cruisers?
Thank you. Ha 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 ha!